Hello, welcome back to theCUBE and our New York Stock Exchange CUBE studio. Of course, we have our studio on the West Coast in Palo Alto, connecting Wall Street and Silicon Valley. I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE. This is our mixture of expert series. We go out to our CUBE alumni and experts to bring them in to unpack some of the trends, the news. We got a returning CUBE alumni many times, CUBE alumni, Saket Saurabh, who's the co-founder and CEO of Nexla. Saket, thank you for coming back and making the time on short notice to hit some of the news around, you know, the big data world, the data platforms, which we've talked about in the past. Thanks for coming on.
Yeah, John, thank you for having me. It's an exciting time here, so much happening.
We just had a week at Dreamforce, which is Salesforce's event, and obviously agentic is the hottest thing. They're now calling Agentforce. You're seeing companies like Confluent, kind of rumor is they're up for sale, kind of not making in the streaming market. Obviously streaming data is super important, but the role of databases, plural, in this new data layer is super important. And so you're starting to see the lines forming of the pre, you know, SaaS era databases and now the post-SaaS, now agentic and generative AI data platforms emerging. And one of the things that we are covering, and it's still ongoing, is the news of two companies merging. You got Fivetran and you got DBT Labs, companies both we've covered in depth as well. Really the pioneers in kind of pushing the envelope on, you know, streaming data, getting data ready for, you know, the data lakes. You got Confluent, as I mentioned earlier. But you're starting to see the consolidation. Those two firms is a significant milestone or indicator of where the market is. I want to get your thoughts on this. You wrote a very interesting LinkedIn post which got our attention. I mean, competition, they turn into competition, they're co-opetition, frenemies, now enemies. This is a game, the pieces are moving on the board. Can you explain from your view what's happening? Again, Confluent, not growing as fast, there's rumors that they're going to try to sell, and Fivetran and DBT merging. What does this mean? What is it pointing to?
So, I think one of the things to remember is that overarching everything, every action is the AI revolution that we are going through. And every company is really thinking their future with AI being the dominant force. So, you know, the applications are what we are all serving as technology companies. And AI applications is the main driver. And to build an AI application, you know, you are taking the model and passing information to that. That's the context. So if you are not going to be the winner as a model company, which is very hard, of course, right? Then you have to be the one building the context, owning the context, right? And that is basically driving all the companies to say, well, how do I really build that context? I need to stitch data from many places. And that's really brought the heat on or the focus on integration companies. That's why Informatica got acquired. And if you look specifically at Fivetran and DBT, Fivetran, $5.6 billion last valuation, DBT, $4.2 billion. So these are giant companies by valuation, right?
Yeah.
But DBT, you know, is solving the problem of creating and managing and running SQL. And that itself is useful, but it is not a $4 billion worth useful. And I think, yeah, so.
So I want to ask you, because one of the things you brought up in your post is they can't go alone. Fivetran needs what DBT had, and DBT needs what Fivetran has. But the comment that jumped out on me was that the modern data stack is dying. And the point was everything was built for analytics. You mentioned that. So I want to talk about that, because analytics and Gen AI are merging. So it's not like, it's hard to be Gen AI when you were optimized for analytics, and it's hard to be analytics if you don't, if you're optimized too much for Gen AI. It's almost like it's a Venn diagram, right? So I want to ask you, with the platform wave, with integrations, what I'm seeing is, and I'd love to get your reaction on this, so I agree with you, by the way, on that, but I want to get your reaction. It seems like with Salesforce and what enterprises are trying to do is be more like a Palantir, right? To be more of a platform where they can get a lot of different data. I use Palantir as a random example, but you know, they claim to have that kind of view. Is that accurate? Is that on point? Is it platforms have to have everything? And if so, what is the new modern stack? I mean, I guess their modern legacy, a term we've been using on theCUBE lately, if it exists, modern legacy is good pre-gen AI, I guess that's modern legacy. But the new modern seems to be platforms. What's your reaction to that, thoughts?
Platforms certainly the new modern. I would differentiate, slightly the fact that Salesforce has a business as a CRM, and they are trying to figure out how they become the platform. Fivetran, Snowflake, Databricks, these are data platforms from the beginning. But the big change from the analytics world to the AI world is analytics was about dumping the data in one place and building your dashboards. AI is about stitching a lot of data in real time and feeding it to the AI. And that sort of changes slightly because now we're not just talking about data which is in tables, but documents and unstructured data and all of that together. So we have sort of moved up from simply data which is structured to context. And context is a lot more beyond that. And context is, everything that you understand that you can want the AI to know so it can help you solve your problem.
Yeah, context was a big theme in agents. So how does this translate to agentic? Because context is something that we see as super valuable in the role of agents, plural. Your thoughts?
Two things on the agentic side. So now we are talking about more converged integration, not just about dumping data, which is one pattern. So think about MuleSoft was one way of doing integration. Informatica ETL was one way of doing it. Fivetran, one way of doing it. We're talking convergence is needed to really feed AI. Okay. When it comes to agentic, the other part that also comes or becomes important is being able to take actions. It's not just about you dropping the data here, but based on this data, you want to take action, you want to trigger some workflow and all of that stuff. So there's another part to agentic. So agentic has two parts in my mind that are really, really important. One is give the context to AI because AI can reason for you, it can plan for you, it can figure out the steps. Great. Then it can execute those steps for you. And to execute the steps, it needs another capability. And if you look at the Fivetran announcement, they also talked about a prior acquisition called Census as sort of the hint that will help them maybe on that front.
Yeah. So on the mergers, less about innovations, more about survival. What do you think that the resulting entity will look like? Will it be the same kind of together? Will there be carnage? Will there be any kind of synergies? Where's the overlap on the product portfolio? What's your thoughts?
Yeah, I think the slight sort of precursor to the story is that both Snowflake and Databricks went ahead and created integration, announced integration solutions in the prior conferences, this year, which means that they were getting into that Fivetran territory that we will do the pipelining. And traditionally, the data storage and the pipelining companies have been good friends, but not necessarily competed at that level. So what Fivetran has done is like, okay, we will, have the integration space and we'll own dbt, which is a very important part of transforming data. And then they're coming out with their own data lake as well, right? So I think what is happening from that perspective is that the Fivetran survival question was that, for me to be relevant, I need to have all of these pieces. I cannot be just the pipeline itself, but then I want to be the data store as well. I want to be the data lake. But then that, I think, flips it back to the other companies to say, well, is Fivetran a full-on competitor to you? Because now they are coming up and saying, store your data in me. I'm not just a transfer mechanism.
So obviously in Silicon Valley, I talked to a lot of folks, and obviously here in New York now on the financial side, consolidation like this is often viewed as a positive. On one side of the coin, you can say, hey, you put them together, make it better. That's more of a private equity kind of vibe. Now, but really kind of on Silicon Valley side, you'd be like, okay, there's no buyers, right? So like my feeling is that the music's kind of stopped. The musical chairs is happening, right? Like, who would buy these companies? Databricks, Snowflake, Salesforce, Palantir, is there an, so it feels like to me a little bit of the musical chairs, the music's kind of stopped. So they kind of look at each other and say, why don't we just combine both in the same portfolio of A16Z? So it's like, okay, better together. Is that a sign that there might not be a robust buying market for these data companies pre-Gen AI and you're out competing? What's your thoughts on this?
Yeah, I think, when you're a $5 billion company, the set of companies that can buy you or for a Fivetran or a dbt is very, very small, right? And it has to really fit in. And if those companies are trying to, or your primary partners are typically your acquirers, right? And if they're competing with you, then it's a hard one to expect, right? I do think that it's good in one way to consolidate, but let's put the customer first, okay? the customer is, in many companies, in many enterprises, is not just on Snowflake. They're also on DB, on Databricks. Right? They use both the platforms in many cases. They're not just on AWS, they're also on GCP or Azure, right? So the fact that each vendor has their own integration platform now, AWS and GCP, and now FiveTrend was one neutral, is like, hey, no matter what you do, I can cover for you. I think the customer might end up questioning, like, okay, so now in future, fast forward, is FiveTrend integration or pipelining going to be first class for their own data lake and then not as first class for others? Like, where will they innovate first? And maybe it's cheaper if you use FiveTrend with their data lake and not if you use it with somebody else. So I think there is going to be, for the customers, a cost question as to how this consolidation impacts them from a pricing perspective, how it also is an innovation question, how this consolidation maybe slows down the innovation that because they need, and large enterprises will need more than one platform. That's definitely the case, right? So I think that's kind of where the real question for us would be. And I do think that my guess is it will, customers may not necessarily be happy with.
Well, I really appreciate you coming in on this breaking analysis of these moves. They're kind of reading the tea leaves, but I really appreciate your commentary. How's business going with you? Nexla, I mean, you're in the space. You're in the integration. The new platforms are emerging. Large scale semi-computers, supercomputers are booming. NVIDIA, AMD. I mean, the infrastructure is like thundering away with power, like horsepower.
Yeah, I mean, as I said, data has become super important. Connecting and orchestrating data to make context is super important. So we're right in the center of it. We're one of the first companies to do Converge. So we, you know, we support applications, documents. Now we just announced support for video files to be processed in our system, all adding to the context. So I think a lot of important problems to solve and enable ultimately the end user. You know, we are the means to the end for them. And for us, you know, certainly we watch the market very, very closely, but staying true to the customer. And I think, you know, giving a very viable alternative to customers, and we feel pretty good about that.
Saket, thank you so much for coming in remotely in our remote. Appreciate it. Thank you. Great to see you. Hope everything stays well.
John.
All right. Thanks for coming on. Okay. I'm John Furrier with theCUBE. We're breaking down the news. As the data market continues, the mixture of experts are weighing in here on theCUBE and the NYC Wired community. You know, as the world's changing, architectural shifts are causing customers to rethink and repackage their infrastructure, their data infrastructure, and how applications and the context is going to be a very, very big conversation around the context of data. Contextual data in the age of agentic will be a super important topic. We'll certainly revisit it many, many times in the next year, of course, and many more to come. I'm John Furrier, your host. Thanks for watching.